Why is this bird changing color?
So one of the cool things about Getty is that there's always these really interesting science experiments happening to further the field of art conservation. And recently, one of my colleagues reached out to me to tell me that they were doing this experiment recoloring dead birds using LED lights, which could have implications on how we conserve cultural heritage objects in the future. And I was like, whoa, you had me at recoloring dead birds.
Vincent Laudato Beltran is a scientist at Getty's Conservation Institute and is working with Ellen Pearlstein and Adam Foster to conduct lighting experiments on birds inspired by some research from 2011.
Some colleagues were using LED lights to try to restore the plumage coloration on birds that were very faded.
But that was over 10 years ago.
But you can imagine how much the technology in light changes over the course of 10 years.
Many cultural heritage objects, such as regalia, incorporate bird feathers, so increasing industry knowledge around color restoration can help conservators and curators better display and communicate about these works of art.
But before we jump into how they recolor birds using light, you might be wondering, why not just physically recolor the feathers using something like a paint or dye?
The issue sometimes is the reversibility of that material on the specimen. It can sometimes be difficult to take it off the specimen, and it then constitutes like a permanent addition to an object, which often is something we're trying to avoid.
So instead of adding back permanent color to an object of cultural significance, after all, you wouldn't repaint over a faded Mona Lisa, the team is seeing what they can do to virtually recolor things so that people might one day be able to see cultural heritage objects in a new light. Get it? New light.
These lights change both the hue of the white light, so you can go from a warmer to a cooler tone, but also there's additional LED lights in there that are red, green, and blue.
One of the interesting things for me is that light and art have this complex relationship, and one of the reasons that art can fade in the first place is because of light.
There's this aspect of light that's going to damage the object. The focus of our work is really on the restorative qualities of light.
In addition to preserving cultural heritage in a new way, the work in and of itself is a fascinating journey.
I think what would be interesting for this project is to create an exhibition in the end where not only is it relighting these specimens with its restored color, but having an opportunity for the public to interact with that color.
The team's work could change the way we tell stories about feathered objects, even these dead birds. For example, a faded bird could be used to show color-based differences in a male versus female bird. Or even just bringing these birds back to life, so to speak, could deeply engage viewers' imaginations.
So the team might not have any concrete plans yet since they're still at the beginning of their work, but their color-changing birds are already starting this cool conversation about the restorative qualities of light, and I'm really interested to see what's next for them. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Becoming Artsy, and stay tuned for more projects, science experiments, art history, and more.